And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Big energy, big fun, big friends.
Smiles, 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 pizzazz.
Razzmatazz, razzmadoo. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Big J. Oakerson. That handsome man over there is Dan Soder.
Who, me?
Yes, you.
You trying to get some kisses on your belly?
Mm-hmm. We're live and...
No, we're not.
Oh, man. I was going to say live and not new again.
We're live. We are indeed not.
This is an afternoon on a Monday. But
it
is. Broadcasting on a Wednesday, 6 p.m. Eastern.
We were saying outside how this is... this becomes difficult, especially since we haven't seen each other in a little while.
2 weeks?
That we got to, like, hold back. I'm edging right now. I'm comedy edging.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm presenting. I'm giving you small things to go in on.
You're peacocking. Yeah. But because we can't talk about the actual time we've spent apart.
Because we did that on Monday.
Yeah.
As our listeners know.
We rammed that in your ear holes on Monday.
Yeah. The old ear fuck with stories.
3 hours from now in the past. Monday.
Terminator timeline, baby. Us and the Terminator. We're the only ones that have these kind of timelines.
Wait, I couldn't have gotten pregnant by Dan if Dan's from the future.
Or did I send someone back from the future to the past to impregnate you?
Go, 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 go.
We always just show up in the Sirius lobby, like Arnold, just naked. Sir, you're naked again in the lobby.
Well, I'm just walking around you holding those things from Spencer's that have like the electric thing.
What? Oh, sir, you're going to have to put on some clothes. You're going to be in the lobby.
Can you
like
please
that.
Give him a wide berth? We do this every time we do a pre-record.
I know you do. I prefer when he's naked, too.
Go, 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 go.
Jay, it's your turn. Strip down.
Go, go, go.
We have to do it back in time.
I go to the security desk. Give me your clothes.
Shut the fuck up, some fat black lady.
I punched four hearts out. I punched through four security guards here.
Yeah, you keep hitting fellow security guards in the chest, sir. We have your picture behind our desk.
I know this is seasonal work, but
ow! It didn't even go through.
Yeah.
Give me your clothes.
Give me your clothes.
You're just wearing one of the security vests that they have. And nothing.
That's it. It's my dork hanging out.
Just says Shauna. And then
Tawana.
Yeah.
It's just her. I just took her name tag. It's just like pinned into my skin.
Just bleeding suddenly. I'm going to the 36th floor.
I don't have a pass.
Can you buzz me in?
This picture always gets me now.
I don't know who put that up there. Jacob? That seems like a Jacob.
Hugo.
Hugo put it up there. It's his political statement. Like, look how not that happy Obama was.
Or also, like, let's come together.
No, I don't think that's what that's about, because that picture's so obviously, like, awkward.
Mm.
The hands aren't even clinched yet.
Maybe Hugo... Is he in the office? Murkface, can you go find Hugo?
Not here.
Oh, damn it.
What's he doing? Get his hair greasy? Is he greasing up his little hairs?
Putting it in his hair. He's just matting it down.
Hugo doesn't even look like he's balding. It looks like he's just still getting in his baby hairs.
Yeah. Hugo looks like every kid I knew growing up who didn't have to have a babysitter when they were left alone.
He was combing a mustache in fifth grade.
His mom's like, I'm going out. And then the door shuts and you go, are you going to get a babysitter?
Like, nah, I'm cool. She's leaves me here with ColecoVision.
ColecoVision. At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. Can we put a picture of Hugo up so people can see it?
God, so bad. Just caption Hugo. This picture always gets me because what's interesting about it is like it really does take you back. So it's the picture of the awkward handshake between Trump and Obama, I believe, at the White House.
Yeah.
And the picture, the still frame here is their hands aren't clinched yet. Trump's looking down.
It looks like the mega powers.
Yeah, and Obama looks like he's annoyed to even do it. But I bet he's fucking really annoyed to do it because you forget, like, through all of that, like, before he was even running for president, Trump was just the main guy. He's like, this guy's not from America.
That's like if someone was heckling you the entire time you're doing your set, and then you had to bring them on stage.
And then he comes over to take over my part of the bonfire.
But then you have to bring him on stage. Like, yeah. He's heckling you the entire time. He's like, you suck! And you're like, all right.
No, but he's really taking his job, so it's not that.
That's what I'm saying. If you brought him on stage.
It's like, I'm leaving the bonfire, And he's my replacement, the guy who's been shitty to me the whole time. And you have to shake his hand at the
end. You have to be like, but you'd have to shake his hand. That's what I'm saying. It works. Stand-up is perfect. If he was heckling
I'm
you,
sorry.
And then you brought him up. Because then you'd have to, that's the handshake you'd have to have. You'd be like, woo! Your next comic has been yelling at me nonstop for 4 years, for 8 years.
Yeah, exactly. It has to be a long-term heckler because this guy's been giving him shit his entire fucking presidency.
Should we pick a radio show to start heckling and then take their jobs?
Yeah, let's go. Let's pick one.
Bob and Tom.
Bob and Tom.
Dig up Tom.
Yeah, really. Like Bob's gone. It's just Tom now.
What if, like...
I think the girl's back, though. Can somebody look that up? Is the girl back? What's the Bob and Tom show like now?
I don't know. I feel like talking about Bob and Tom, it's like it's something I never got into, so it's almost like bringing up Law and Order. You're like, hey, that could be a character. I have no idea who the fuck that is.
I'm still blown away that you have no idea who Mariska Hargitay is.
What is that? Who is that?
Oh, my God.
That sounds like a figure skater. Benson. Benson from who? From Law and Order?
See, oh, look, and that's the other thing. That Kostaki dude is back in the...
I like Kostaki. He's always been nice to me.
I'm not arguing that he's not nice. I'm just saying he's taken over, I think, the oh, Chick. You hated Chick.
Yeah, he's mean to me until I told him my friend was the wide receivers coach for the Redskins.
Fuck Chick. By the way, I remember I'm looking at a picture of Chick McGee. He looks like it sounds like a fake name you'd call like a jerk off.
It sounds like a delivery name you get.
Yeah, it's like hey, is this a call chief or buddy?
Yeah.
Hey, Chick McGee, what do you got here? What's on tap? What kind of microbrews you got?
You're going too fast down a hill on a bike. Oh, watch out, Chick McGee! Chick McGee, get out of the way!
Hey, Chick McGee, slide over. Coming through, coming in hot.
Coming in hot.
Hey, Chick McGee. Go up back to Chick McGee's picture. I swear to you, I remember this guy being 40 years older than this picture.
He definitely has hot girlfriend dad face.
What do you mean?
Like your hot girlfriend's mean dad?
Oh, yeah.
And where he's like, so are you going to bring Jenna back on time? Like he just says subtly shitty stuff like that.
And he acts like he'd still fight, but he can't.
Yeah.
You can whoop his ass, but he still treats you like you can't.
Yeah.
And out of respect, you just like, you know, it's like, oh, yeah, no, I don't want to have a problem with your dad.
But then you
and
get in the
quite
car.
Quite honestly, I can beat the shit out of your father.
0-60 Soder punches the steering wheel and just goes, is he ever going to respect me? Damn, you got to chill out. My dad's like, he's hard to deal with. And I know that.
But...
And why do you think,
I know he loves you.
Why do you think I love to have my head just beamed off the backboard of your bed every night?
He's very tough on me. That's why I let you plow me out in this Datsun.
Yeah, and you know my dad's really tough on me, and that's why you always have a fistful of hair whenever you come.
Now, do you want to finger me to this Ed Sheeran CD or not? I'm saying that because I see Ed Sheeran in the corner.
I was like, all right, yeah, cool.
Sure, Ed Sheeran, I guess. All right, go down. What's going on in the Bob and Tom world? Let's find out. We could do this.
So are we doing this in order to take their job?
Heckle Let's take them? Their job. Let's take the middle
but
of the country.
But there's no job. The middle of the country doesn't want us.
You're wrong with it. Oh, man, that sucks.
What?
Look who's coming in Wednesday. Go up.
Can't even say it, but it's Merkface's ex.
It's Merkface's ex. She's doing great.
That's almost like a perfect sign that we need to heckle these guys then.
Oh, you think she left you because she's going to bang Kostaki, a cop in Monopolis?
Or Chick McGee.
She's going to bang Chick McGee.
She's trying to get all that string of that fleece dick.
Andy, I'm calling you. I feel really bad. I blew Chick McGee. He got me tickets to local Indianapolis culture.
That sounds like a sentence you would say in the 20s.
And that's right. Another thing. She blew Chick McGee.
He took me to the Please Touch Museum and out for Denny's.
Oh, we went to a very local restaurant that only people in Indianapolis would appreciate.
But when he helped me, I felt something.
But we were watching TV and he helped me. I said, this feels right.
We watched 3 seasons of Lost in a row.
And it all finally made sense.
I finally get what all the hubbub's about.
Everyone came down hard on Abrams, but I get it.
It's about your heartbeat syncing up and watching a show together.
You have to watch it in love to understand it. Merkface. She starts calling him Merkface.
So wait, the island. Merkface, you don't understand. The island was purgatory.
Chick whispered all of the secrets in my ear.
Did you know Harold Perrineau was also in Oz and Romeo and Juliet remake? I learned so much from Chick because he's 80 or 60.
He has the face of a wise car dealer.
He He has the head that should be wearing a cowboy hat, but doesn't.
That's legitimate spit.
Oh, we got Merc face to spit takes. So that's all that matters.
Oh, your ex is boinking. She's getting spit roasted by Kostaki, a cop, and a mopple of Melissa. Why would you change your name?
What a running downhill of a name. Kostaki.
Kostaki. Economopolis.
You're falling downstairs.
Oh, my. Kostaki. Yeah. Throw me a... Just change to Papadopoulos like every other fucking... You know, it's funny, though. A lot of times with the Greek people who are famous, too, they just take off the opolis.
Yeah.
So, but then his name would be Kostaki Ekonom.
That's actually awesome.
Ekonom.
So, yeah, that's basically what Trump did to Obama is what we just did.
Oh, it's fucking so great.
But now we got to take the middle of the country, as you said.
Look at it. Who they love? Rodney Carrington, who every one of his album covers is him covering his dick with, like, a chainsaw or something.
Bring it up!
Oh, Rodney Carrington comedy? Please. Please bring that up. I'd love to.
Do you know him? Have you ever met him?
No.
Okay.
Have you?
No.
I want to know. I want to go through right now. Here's a fun thing.
He's got a cowboy hat on.
Let's go through truck stop comedy tape. Comedy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
I thought he was a black dude. I thought Rodney Carrington. I was like, this is going to be a black dude.
It sounds like a wide receiver for the Saints.
Oh, man. Fucking Carrington had it at the 15 and he dropped it.
Oh, alligator arms Carrington.
That's going to be Drew Brees going to drop back in the pocket. And across the 40, he's got Rodney Carrington. Oh, he drops the ball.
Let's take it over to our sports guy, Chick McGee.
Oh, that's right. I can beat you up, but I can beat you up, too.
Nice sports facts, Chick McGee. That's like the insult.
Oh, dude. Is he? I mean, he's doing the Majestic Theater. That's a big theater.
Of course, dude.
What song is this?
It's called A Letter to My Penis.
That's all we needed to get by.
He's jacked. Is that him?
Oh. Yeah, this guy can fight us both.
But that dude's diesel.
Yeah, but he hasn't come to the coasts.
He's all flyover only.
Just lay low. Don't do Bob and Tom.
I'm on a flight to Seattle. We got to land in Kansas. I can't flyover state.
So you don't understand. I will cash in my Delta dollars. I cannot land.
400,000 miles right now. Take them all. Get me to at least Texas. I need to go to Minnesota. Can you aim it north?
Well, look, it's all he wants you to know. It's all white trash. He's putting on some cheese whiz on his thing.
No, he put cheese whiz. Rewind that a little bit, Christine.
Not cheese whiz. The, what do you call that? Now I want it so bad, by the way.
Oh.
That kind of cheese.
Oh, no.
What's that shit called? I grew up with it at my house every week.
Easy whiz.
Easy cheese.
Easy cheese.
At the Majestic. Where's the Majestic? Where is that?
I don't know. He's got a piano in a sold-out house.
You said the Majestic...
Majestic Theaters, I've been inside it. I can't remember. Was Nashville?
Oh, no, dude, listen. He's got his following like a motherfucker.
Oh, so this one.
I'm not arguing that.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, he's like the top of the heap of...
Hey, hit the volume. I want to hear how he opens. I think he said the name, too.
What's up, faggots? Oh, Jesus.
I had a great day today. I got up this morning. I played golf.
Pause it. With three guys. I'm already angry at the happening to me today. I can't believe he's opening a Majestic Theater with a "This happened to me today." I got pulled over on the way here.
I noticed that y'all. Where is the Majestic?
Dallas.
That's where it was. I was just there. That's why I walked by it.
Is he jacked or is he built like?
Dude, he's built like a brick shit house.
Was that somebody else?
I don't know. That was some Rambo shit. Him getting ready at the beginning of his special.
Also, he looks like Chick McGee's fucking old used car lot partner. They split off and went their own ways. I deal exclusively in Buicks.
I grew up with Chick. He was my best friend, and I'll fight you in the mouth. All I do is pull ups on the road. I had the same reaction David Carrington did in Rambo, where he takes his shirt off. I was like, oh god. From
Koresh.
Correct. No.
No. I know.
I was like, from Waco? Who's the guy that's in CSI Miami? David. Not David Carrington.
Caruso.
David Caruso. Why are we watching this?
Wait, hold on. I want a David Caruso. Can you do the Miami? Can you do the CSI Miami? So I could David Caruso his biceps? Rodney. Yeah. I'm going to put my sunglasses on. That's the thing that I used to love David Spade used to do on the Spade's Hollywood Minute, where he would do different, cause you know, if you do the beginning of CSI Miami, they always hit with the Who.
Yeah.
And right as he puts his sunglasses on at a murder scene. I want to do that with Rodney Carrington. That's David Caruso. Yeah, that it is right there. But hold on, I gotta wait for the break right there. Wait, it starts quick. Start it over again. David Carrington looks like damn it. Looks like he's carrying more than you know what? This is going real south, real quick.
I wanted to say that Rodney,
this unfurled quickly.
Rodney Carrington is wearing those kind of fucking stiff dungarees, so you always have a boner.
Wait, hit play. Looks like he's carrying more than just a load. Looks like he's carrying a boner.
He's carrying a ton. Pow!
Listen, folks, they're not all going to be golden
eggs.
Wait,
back up and start him over.
Sometimes you shit out of rotten
egg. I want to hear about what happened to him today. Did he get pulled over?
Oh, is this? By the way, this is his special live at the Majestic, which you can buy. We're promoting it, so technically we're doing a good thing.
Which you could buy.
You know, before the shirt on. It's before he does a shot and eats a cracker of Cheese Whiz. Right there. Damn! That can't be him.
That's not him.
Jacob. Do you really think that's him?
Although maybe, because the cover of some of his albums, he's like shirtless and he is in really good shape.
Yeah, dude, look at those arms. You can see him through the shirt. That's him.
So it turns out that cowboy wear is the most unflattering clothing ever.
Yeah.
Because you always got to be burlapped up in case you fall off a horse.
You can't get fucking dirt rash from falling off the steed.
Your clothes are always thick in case you get dragged by something.
I can get dragged.
I fell over an ATV. Oh, God.
Thank God I was wearing my thicker than hell denim. Thank God I was
got dragged 14 miles, not a rip in these sumbitches.
Yeah, this cotton shirt's also made of half chain mail, so I can't really get hurt. But turns out you can't see my beefy bod. That's why I gotta put it on every fucking. All right, start it. I want to hear how. I mean, they're going ape shit.
Yeah. Well, yes.
It's the beginning of a special. Puts down a red solo cup.
Thank you, Dallas, Texas.
All right, we get it.
God, it's so good to be here. I had a great day today. I got up this morning, I played golf, hooked up with three guys that I didn't know.
And dragged the black from my cart.
I was the first one to tee off and just right down there, you know. And
you played golf today?
I turned to one of them. I said, is that a good place to be? And the guy says, no, if you need to take a shit, it is.
Huh?
And I had to, so it worked out real good.
What the fuck was that?
He even makes faces like that one eyebrow, like, you know what I'm laying there, cheap
what
hoes?
What kind of uncle humor beginning is that? I was playing golf today. Dan's a comedian. You'll appreciate this. Come over here. What the fuck kind of open was that?
You may have heard me ripping on the radio this morning, my good friend Kostaki Kakamanopoulos.
I was playing golf, hooked up with three dudes, didn't golf with them, just sucked them all right in the cart shack.
Chick McGee, Chick McDee, Kostaki Kakamanopoulos.
And Bob, or Tom, I forget which one died.
The one with the stash, and the other one with the hat.
Yeah. Wow. That,
keep
that
going.
Is, no, I mean, all right, I guess we're doing this today.
I didn't have a golf towel. Then I got back, and I got a massage, which I love, which I don't do that often.
What a day.
I don't understand the whole concept of a massage.
Just talking to a theater of people, how he pampers himself.
I'm saying today, he says he did all this.
Let me tell you what I did today.
Then
I went on and bought a very expensive car for a friend that I rarely talk to. Oh, y'all have money troubles, Dallas?
I went on a hike, broke up with my girlfriend, met a new girl, got engaged, went golfing.
Yeah, Rodney Carrington is the subtle Ric Flair. I hate to bring up my day, but some things went pretty good.
Christine, back up, because he just, whatever that little shuffle he did, I have to hear what was around that.
Oh, God. I didn't know we were going to get this piece of gold.
Go back.
Oh, third round draft pick, Rodney Carrington really is my favorite.
We got to hear it. You won't take
then
a
I got
shit
back
here.
And I got a massage, which I love, which I don't do that often.
But Asians, I will hardly allow to touch me.
A massage. You get a woman to rub all over every single part of your body, except the one part you really won't rub, no. And it's not like she didn't know what part I was talking about. I kept pointing at it, clearing my throat.
Oh, so you were... Just bullying a woman in the jerking you off.
He's the.
She just left.
He's the
yeah. She went. Hey, that guy's trying to get me to rub his dick. I don't want to do that.
This is a sports medicine facility, sir.
Sir, I graduated from Penn State with a bachelor in biological engineering. I'm actually getting my doctorate here at SMU. I'd prefer if you'd stop harassing me.
I just, you know, I pointed at it, and I went, it ain't gonna suck itself. You
it's
stupid
a little sticky,
slut.
A little sticky from being in my dungarees.
Sorry if you got some denim heat coming off. I got thrown from a mule and I was
that some bitch bucks.
But besides that, a pretty good day.
Anyway, earlier today I got kicked by a donkey.
I was born earlier today. Rodney, you can't be born in the same day you're talking about.
Today I hang glided down the Grand Canyon, you know, on the way to get here. My dick hanging out.
This guy, you know, we don't need to trash him. He's
huge.
Decapitate.
But he is.
Truck stop comedy?
I want to follow up on what's like the top truck stop comics?
Yeah, that's a good guess. Yeah. Fucking Andy's boy, Larry's the number one.
Oh, of course. Yeah. But I'm telling you, there's people who just have albums available at. I get offered that once. Someone said, he goes, oh, yeah, you do an album for us and it'll be in all the truck stops all over the country. And I was like, no. I'm okay. I'm like, I'd rather not do that.
Like, it's a pretty good deal.
You end up on one of those compilations.
Oh, yeah.
You know
what would you be on? You'd be on one of those East Coast liberal fags of comedy.
The Muff Munchers of comedy. Yeah.
If you want to hear some commie liberal from the ocean side of this country tell you what to who to think for and how to talk and...
Weasel.
Christine, any luck sniffing out who the top fucking truck stop comics are? Because I'll tell you this, if they're as jacked as Rodney Carrington, we can forget this subject right after the first break.
Have you ever seen the Hispanic Rodney Carrington, Gabriel Iglesias in Hawaii?
Oh, yeah, the opposite. He's the opposite of Rodney Carrington.
Gabriel does that thing where he opens his shows wherever he's at with, like, something about the town, which I hate that so much. Where he's like, oh, last time I was here, I came to that McDonald's over there on 3rd Street.
I usually talk about the people, but I don't think I do. I'm wondering, I was like, as you were saying that, I'm like, do I do that?
No, if you got something about the city in general, but it's always just like, yeah. it's just like, remember this, like, it's like cheer because I know.
Oh,
this
because
thing,
of
know
a location or,
was,
yeah,
oh
yeah.
Man, this is crazy. I can't believe last time I came here, I went down to Johnson's Mall over there on 18th Street. I've been there. He's like me.
Man, I have some history in this town.
And Gene Tracy is clearly a truck
who
stop
is
comic.
Gene Tracy? I'm going to learn
Jerry
about
Jerry Die.
Oh, God. We're going to learn about so many truck stop comedians today on The Bonfire. And you, bitch, when we pre-record fans.
You motherfucker.
Yeah, sure. I might have eaten dick with that David Carradine thing.
I thought it was great. It's yeah. David Caruso is
no,
the problem you're at.
I refuse to call him by his real name now. Who is this?
Is that Gene Tracy?
It's going to be wild tonight. Yeah. See some wild things coming over here. So I stopped one time, stopped the stop sign, and here were two drunks laying in the gutter, just drunker than hell. One of them had his finger stuck up the other one's ass. And I sat down, a policeman walked by and said, what in the hell is going on?
What in the hell?
This drunk had his finger stuck up the other one's ass. He said, well, this here is my friend. And he's sick, and I'm trying to make him throw up. He said, well, God Almighty. Said, you ain't going to make him throw up that way. He said, the hell I ain't. You wait till I take this finger and stick it in his mouth.
It's a good joke. I like it.
But it's a joke.
I like it. I like truck stop comedy. I never thought I would.
I love it.
I'm a big fan of truck stop comedy. I think it's number one. I want to publicly apologize to Rodney the Diesel Carrington.
Rodney the Mule Carrington.
Rodney, fucking don't get bucked from this horse, Carrington, and all other truck stop comedians.
It's so funny. It's just like it really is. It's like you're. It's like instead of just like having a friend drive with you, it's like playing a tape of a guy sitting next to you.
Yeah. You just put a...
And there you go. I know a good one. Oh. Two
Jews walking.
Man, if you're a trucker, please email us at the bonfire.
Tell us who your favorite trucker comedian is.
At SiriusXM.com, and then we'll go over it next week. Monday, we've got a great episode already planned. But Wednesday, Monday, we've been talking about Monday's episode just before this show, and it just got me, I don't know, as excited for the live show.
What do you mean?
With what we talked about, what we're going to do on Monday?
Oh, yeah.
But it got me really excited.
I mean,
because I might miss it, but I might not.
There's a good chance you're not going to miss it, which is so great.
Yeah.
Can I just see, for the sake of argument, what the farting contest is? Because that's just over there in related videos. And it's called the Battle at Thunderblow. Windsmere versus Boomer.
Eyewitness report of the first international trepidation contest. We are speaking to you from the ringside of the great Maple Leaf Auditorium, which is packed to the rafters with spectators, eager and curious. For the benefit of my listeners who are not acquainted with the facts relating to this event, it might be well to describe the two contestants. Lord Windsmere from Wapping Foghole in Devonshire is, of course, the champion of the British Empire. The challenger is Paul Boomer, native son of Australia, who I understand...
Is this real?
...worked his way to Canada in the crew of an ocean freighter carrying a load of Melbourne cabbage, upon which...
Paul Boomer versus Lord Windsmere?
Yeah, this is an old radio bit.
I see now there's a bit of a flurry around Lord Windsmere's entrance. And yes, here Lord Windsmere. I'll see... Oh, two fuzzy... I beg your pardon, three fuzzy farts in rapid succession. It's amazing.
Wow, this is on record.
Yeah.
I didn't know the fart joke went back to records.
Are you kidding me? I think the fart joke's probably the oldest joke. It has to be the first joke.
On phonograph?
On phonograph? Well, what are you going to put on phonograph? I'll tell you exactly what we are. A fart.
Farts.
How about a whole lots of them? How about a whole disc of farts?
A whole heap.
Now, here's the best part. You get the funny noise without the smell. It's a win-win. You get to laugh and you don't throw up.
What better way to go to our first break than a farting contest?
Well, we should have a real one where one of us shits by accident. We should do an updated version of 2016. Hey, shitting! Hey, we will hire Jim Ross to call it.
Oh, my God! Someone stop the damn match! This is crazy!
Wait, that'd be great to approach Jim Ross. We want to redo the farting contest with you.
Mm.
Okay. All right.
I'm listening.
All right.
I'm listening.
Yeah, let's take our first break.
And we'll be right back, y'alls. Okay. It's the bonfire.
I'm going to throw up.
And now back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah!
I love them too, Rodney!
Rodney! Rodney! Rodney! Encore!
That ain't the song.
Ah, we are back. It's the bonfire. That's Rodney Carrington's Titties and Beer. Bring us back in. Big J. Oakerson, Dan Soder, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95.
The Rambo of truck stop comedy, Rodney Carrington.
He don't take no shit.
You can get thrown off a horse.
Man, it's so ridiculous.
Titties and Beer. I love titties.
Of course.
I can't drink beer because I'm an alcoholic.
But you can't drink beer because you love it.
I do.
Love
you
it
know what?
Too much.
Can I say this? I do. I love titties and beer, too. I love titties and beer so much that I had to stop one of them.
For the first time.
And it ain't titties. Brumsky.
Where the fuck was Jacob this whole time? Was Jacob masturbating Jacob, titties and beer?
Were you calling Rodney on the phone in an office?
Rodney, this has nothing to do with me. I'm sorry.
Hey, it's Jake. Listen, I got to I got it real quick. I got to get back in there. It's a pre-record, so their commercials don't last as long as live shows. They're going after you. They know. Chip, too. Tell Chip. Is he there? Is he in the room? Put him on the phone. McGee, it's me. Patat. Hey, McGee, it's me. Jake. It's Jake. Yeah. There you go. Okay. They're coming after you.
Oh, I wonder if Jacob got a big money job working on the Bob and Tom show, if he would leave and take it.
Would you leave us for the Bob and Tom show to live in Indianapolis, Jacob?
Absolutely not.
Oh, I thought he was going to stop it. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Fuck yeah.
You ever been to Broad Ripple?
Titties
Hello.
And beer. Titties and beer.
Oh,
I love me some titties and motherfucking beer. Thank God I'm not queer.
Rubbing elbows with CM, Chick McGee, and Kostaki Kakiopagopoulos.
Morning, Chip. How about those skins, huh?
Hey, guys. What's going on with Andrew Luck this year? He's football, right?
Hey, Jacob, it's me, Andrew Luck. I couldn't play the game on Thanksgiving because I was injured.
Can you bring up an interview of Christine? Bring up an interview of Andrew Luck, because I'm pretty sure that's exactly how his voice sounds.
He's got like a
Sounds almost exactly like. I think I can learn how to do a perfect Andrew Luck.
Like you're slowing a record down.
Everybody,
the game was.
There he is.
Let's hear it.
And I represent red in the fade blue.
As he strains to. Oh.
He's investigation.
Something there. Wait a minute. NYPD. Something's wrong.
Fart contest, come back.
It's funny to watch Christine like with like a fart contest on.
Titties and beer. Titties and beer.
Scrambling.
I'm excited to play in the NFL.
I love to throw the ball.
Titties and beer.
I love to throw the ball as fast as possible.
Hootin' and sitting around you, but do titties and beer.
Okay, I know that you've had a ton of stuff to do over this weekend.
Yeah, no, it's great. It's obviously it's fun to be with all the other rookies. And, you know, I got a couple teammates here, and Dwayne and Kobe.
What the fuck is happening behind this?
I don't know, Christine. What is happening?
Sort of hammer out some of the memorabilia.
I hammer out some of the writing memorabilia. Is she a great big fat person?
Green
giant. I have green beans. I've got asparagus.
I'm working on a sweet pea.
And a suit made of skin.
Now, I know you'd think normally canned carrots are not something that people would be into, but it's a Thanksgiving delicacy.
I also look like if Dan Soder had a normal size head and any athletic ability.
I'd probably be getting berating puss on him, but it's me.
But it's not. It's me.
He grows that patchy white trash beard most of the time, though.
Not. You hope not. What's that been like? Because you haven't been able to really join the team.
I always love local sports anchor energy.
How's your weekend been? Well, my weekend's been pretty good. I went golfing today.
Yeah. And then I flew in yesterday hanging out, got pulled over by a cap.
That's how he opens every set. It's just how awesome his life is.
Woke up in a bed made of money. I rolled over to my gorgeous wife. I said, just another day of being me.
Put on my favorite morning music, Tilldale Records Fart Contest.
That's what I think. That's what I listen to when I'm doing my thinking in the shower.
How many of these football players do you think... there'll never be a way to find this out. We could look it up. I bet there's rumors. But like Pam Oliver and Doris Burke. How many of them get fucked by the athletes?
So there was a really interesting article where one of... I forgot who it was. Was it Aaron Andrews? I don't think it was Aaron Andrews.
Oh, she's the one that was naked through the keyhole.
Yeah, that was... I couldn't even look at those, man. That was too much.
I couldn't look at them either. They were very blurry. I couldn't look at them either because my direct line to the closed circuit that was that thing I put in her room.
Yeah, find out who slept with Brian Greasy. There was a girl that used to... there was a lady that worked for, I want to say, ESPN. It wasn't Aaron Andrews. It was before her. And I remember reading an ESPN the magazine article, and they were like, do players hit on you a lot as a sideline reporter? And she's like, all the time. And she's like, they're like, has it ever gone farther? This was, I want to say, 10 to 15 years ago in ESPN the magazine. Like, has it ever gone farther than flirting? And she goes, two guys, and I won't name names. Actually, I'll name one name because he never called me back, Brian Greasy. And you're like, oh, get it, girl? He's fucking the quarterback.
I hope he was. Was he greasy?
No. But I bet it happens more than you think.
I'm gonna.
Well, one of them married Christian Ponder. She was just reporting on the game I was watching this weekend.
An athlete married her.
Yeah, she married the quarterback Christian Ponder.
I wonder when they first come in, how many just like run up through them. They really can't announce it to lose their like.
Well, I bet they avoid it. There's like certain things. I know the Denver Broncos, Pat Bowlen, my buddy, when he worked for them, or even when he was like a kid, but when he worked for them, he told me there was an agreement that players don't talk to the cheerleaders. I think they try to like keep them, you know.
If I played on a team, I'd bang all the cheerleaders. You know what? They stopped calling them cheerleaders. That's why they call them the dance teams now.
Why?
So you can fang them. So I won't bang the cheerleaders, but I'm going to bang all the Sixers dance team. They're so Philly hot.
What, the Sixers dance team?
Particularly the Sixers dance team.
They're
so Philly hot.
Sixers dance team.
But remember the one reporter got upset because, like, you know, didn't Favre send his, like, weird flat hammerhead dick?
Dude, she does comedy now. Jen Sturger? I think that's her name.
Remember that weird-shaped dick he has?
Yeah, she was working for the Jets as a sideline reporter, and then he sent her a text of her dick.
It looks like he would get boners, and then somebody would, like, fucking, like, fly helmet right into his fucking dickhead.
Or slam an Acme anchor like Roadrunner.
It's so weird.
And Wild E. Coyote on his dick.
His dickhead is like his dickhead is like a half inch from like bottom of the mushroom to the top.
Do you think that's why he's so careless on the field when he played? Because he's like, I don't care. My dick got smashed when I was a baby. You think I can blink at an interception?
I haven't felt my dickhead in forever.
Oh, there's your Philly girls.
They got to get up on them, though. You almost got to bring up like a website of the Philly dancers. They're just so, like, they're really Philly hot chicks.
The one in the middle is crazy hot.
No, they're all really hot, but they're so Philly.
If you find a picture, Christine. I do like seeing their choreography, though. I respect their choreography.
Oh, yeah. They do pretty hoary dances, too.
I mean, that's standard.
They're called the dance team, Christine. There's your problem. God.
There they are.
She doesn't want me to see them.
She hates you enjoying anything.
Zoom in on this bitch. Or these. I'm sorry. That was.
They're women, Jay.
These bitches.
Thank you. It's plural.
I meant bitch in the picture. So, oh, Philly garbage. It is great.
Are they all from Philly?
Yeah, our friend Rocco used to fuck Philly's dance team girls.
Really?
Yeah, of course.
I love Rocco.
Hey.
I follow him on Instagram just for his sauce.
Hey. Do you really give you sauce recipes?
He cooks sometimes, and I watch it.
Dude, Rocco, I mean, like some of my favorite Joe DeRosa stories in the world are Rocco stories.
Rock, here it is.
Rocco's so Philly, he just makes his own.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Pick one.
Let's go through Nicki. Nicki Minaj.
You look Nicki on the bottom there, huh?
Well, I can't really see it. I don't have my glasses on.
Yeah, she's fantastic.
Yeah.
Her favorite television show is Grey's Anatomy.
Is that still on the air?
If you could have one food on Earth, or if you had to vote for the best food on Earth, what food would you vote? This is great, dude. Going through fucking cheerleader questions. What would be the one food you'd pick to have your vote for the best food on Earth?
Quesadillas.
She's like, I don't know, whatever's warm after I take one.
The best book she's ever read is Fault in Our Stars. Go throw a dagger. Let's just go throw a dart.
Michelle.
Let's see what Michelle's deal is.
Michelle's smoking hot.
They're all. Her favorite movie is Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs.
No, that's for children.
That is for small children.
Yeah, that's for children who can't follow storylines.
She's like, I like it because it's heady. It's really deep. It's got layers.
She's been a dancer for 4 years. If you had to vote for the best food on Earth, what would have your vote? Anything buffalo chicken.
What? That's a pretty Philly answer.
Oh my God. What song do you want to play if you were walking to a quiet room full of people? Come With Me Now by Congos.
Can you please play that, Lou? Because I want to know exactly what she's talking.
I want to know what all of their favorite songs are now.
She likes accordion? Oh. Come with me now. I mean, that's what you want to play when you walk in? What? Who's here? Where's the accordion? Oh, it's just Michelle.
Oh, you bitch. I thought it was the polka team coming in here.
Oh, I got so excited. Look at Rachel from Hatfield, Pennsylvania.
Hatfield.
Coming in from Hatfield, Pennsylvania.
She's a recruiter in an IT staffing company.
If you're
her
allowed...
favorite memory is dancing in China.
If she was allowed one app on her phone, that app that she would choose would be Camera. By the way, I'm pretty sure that's a standard issue. I don't think that's an app.
Yeah, that's not.
Pretty sure
that's
just a function.
But okay.
Because like being the guy who's listening to him fill out the survey goes like this. Camera? Well, that's not really an app, so let's move on to the next one.
Christine.
That would be what do you love most about her?
Oh, you stupid bitch. Christine, how much do you hate that if she had to choose one food on Earth, it would be cookies?
She never eats cookies.
Does that make you furious? I know that's why she wants
never
them.
Eats them.
Do you want to force feed her a cookie?
Cookies and look like that.
Do you want to force feed her?
I'm not Jen Kober.
Do you know what she loves about Philadelphia? The history and the attitude.
It'd be great if you're like, I wish we could do a trivia with these girls, a Philly trivia, to see who knows more about Philly, you or three of these dancers.
I don't know anything about Philly.
We could definitely reach out.
We should reach out and try to do a trivia game.
Me versus three Sixers dancers?
Yeah, in Philadelphia history.
And then I'll have a dance-off with them also.
That'd be a great...
Oh, my God. Look how hot Carrie is.
Oh, wow. Yeah, she's like...
She's been a Sixers dancer for 7 years. She's a little long in the tooth. She's from Bethlehem. She can't live without coffee. Her favorite movie, Rudy.
All right.
The best book she's ever read, The Twilight Saga. These are children.
I want one of them to be like Fedor Dostoevsky's Crime and Punishment. And you're like, wow, all right, get it.
I would eat this chick's box the second I met her because what does she love most about Philadelphia? Cheesesteaks.
How many times do you think she's actually eaten cheesesteaks?
I don't know.
But I'm going to give her one.
I'm going to do the bachelor party Nick the Dick move, though, where I put my dick in her cheesesteak.
And she goes like this. She goes, I guess that's what comes on a cheesesteak.
But the thing is, my dick's not big enough to fit through a whole cheesesteak, so she's just going to pull it off of my dick if she grabs it by the other end.
Oh, my God, there's a slimy dick.
Why was your dick in my cheesesteak?
Were you burnt? You burnt?
I guess I'm just going to eat this 3/4 of it then.
I'm just going to have this bread with cheese in it.
I'll eat the 3/4 your dick didn't hit.
Thanks. I mean, there's still enough meat for me to fill up, I guess.
I mean, you were buried in there, and you only messed up one little part.
Yeah. It's like you didn't even touch it.
Christine, great news, though. If she had to pick the best food on earth ever, it would be pasta. Just real carb-heavy.
Yeah, none of these girls are like fruit salads. That's all I can have.
I love it.
I want to see what...
go to Aaliyah. She's got pudge cheeks.
I want DaVita. Oh, Aaliyah, too. She's young. Okay.
Oh, she's from Drexel
They're
Hill.
They're all young.
Yeah.
There's no favorite old Sixer dancers.
Favorite movie in the world. In the history of movies, all movies, Citizen Kane's in the world, Scarface, Goodfellas, Bad Boys... Bad Boys 2 is her favorite movie.
Dude, this is great.
They really hit their stride, I think, in part two.
This is my favorite answer, though. You're allowed... Oh, okay. Damn it. I didn't even read the question.
You know what's great about that? I love that. What's the best book you've read? The Great Gatsby, which is so funny because Christine always pretended to like that book because some guy told her it was good.
Did you ever read The Great Gatsby, Christine?
Yeah, of course I've read The Great Gatsby.
Okay.
But then some guy said he really loved The Great Gatsby, so she was like, yeah, I'm going to brush up on it so I have something to talk about between beach.
So good at Shakespeare.
Oh, God, I am so good at Shakespeare.
He's so good at Shakespeare.
Oh, my God.
I'm so happy. That's the first time I heard that drop. I really thought Christine said that. I looked away from her face. My face hurts because I'm smiling too much. I really thought she just randomly said that. I love that drop.
Oh, it's great. Dude, DaVita looks like Theo Ratliff's in a fucking wig.
I was going to say she looks like Angela Bassett when she played Tina Turner.
By the way, more than one of these girls.
I know the damn song, Ike. I wrote this. I know the damn lyrics.
Job in the city. Working for the man every night and day when I'm a fashion stylist and a blogger and I never lost 6 years of Sixers dancer experience.
This is the second now I'm interested. We have to go through all of them because this is the second one that we've clicked on. When asked what their favorite television show is, they say Pretty Little Liars.
Pretty Little Liars.
It's
they all say they can't live without their camera and Instagram.
It's on CW.
CW's the best. It's got the best. What's the best books you've read?
The Divergent series. Also
Please
available
say a
in
book
my...
that isn't based on a movie.
No.
All of you watched
movies. No,
movies.
That's not my problem. Please say a book that isn't currently... They didn't read the books. They could be quizzing the books because they've watched the movies that are currently coming out.
That's what I'm saying.
Out.
They're all movie books.
No,
Great Gatsby,
but
Divergent series.
But they're tweener things. Like the... When she walks into a quiet room full of people, she wants the song Overjoyed by Stevie Wonder. First of all, who wrote these questions so weirdly specific? Just say, what's your favorite food?
Because I'll tell you this.
What's your favorite food?
He goes, I'll tell you
why. If you had to pick the best food on earth, what food would you vote for?
I'll tell you why right now. Because these dum-dums can't be corralled as easy into an answer. So they have to have, it's like the way lawyers drop questions for court. They're like, I need a specific answer out of you.
You go, what's your favorite song? What's your favorite song? The question number 9 in this thing is always, if you were to walk into a quiet room full of people, what song would you choose to play?
Because they have to lead the horse to water. They can't just ask them like, hey, what song do you like a lot? They're like,
I like lots of songs.
Describe your favorite, Davina. Describe your favorite,
Davina. We got
Davina. Describe your Davina. For 5 seconds, please, Davina. Describe your favorite memories. Davina!
They had to have
as a Sixers dancer. Describe your favorite memories as a Sixers dancer.
They had to have the junior partner.
We went to China once.
The junior partner of whatever law firm represents the Philadelphia 76ers has to draw these questions up. He's like, oh, God, this is so labor intensive. If you were able to pick a song in a quiet room filled with people that you wanted their reaction, what song?
All right, Natasha looks like the most well in the fuck.
Ooh,
Wow.
Yeah, Natasha's nice. Yeah. Well, let's see how dumb she is. Her favorite television show is Empire, a very new show.
All right.
Wait. If she had to pick her favorite food on Earth, potatoes au gratin?
Wow. Really? She goes,
I know it's a little fancy.
It's pretty niche that I love potatoes done au gratin style.
Sorry. I know it's a little, like,
I love
high-end.
A thin-sliced, well-cooked potato with a thick, creamy-based sauce, also known as au gratin.
I promise you this. Where's she from? East Windsor, New Jersey. I bet you this white pile of garbage has never had potatoes au gratin that wasn't with that
movie?
That wasn't made with the fucking box where you like.
That's all I had growing up.
Oh, me too. Loved it, by the way.
So I kind of get where she's coming from.
I know, but why does my body not look like hers? Why we both love potatoes au gratin so much?
It's my favorite too.
Her favorite book, City of Embers. There you go.
We have another. Wait, this is another candidate for Jay's trivia game because what she loves most about Philadelphia.
The Philadelphia History Museum and the Liberty Bell.
We might have a team captain here for the Sixers.
She just loves the Liberty Bell.
I just love bells that are cracked. I just love it.
Like that's a cracked bell. I'm a dumbbell. I lift barbells. I'm a bell chick.
Yeah.
Another Pretty Little Library. We already saw this one.
Yeah, we've already.
That's the one that was the favorite song. What was the song for that? No, go back. Natasha.
Love myself. Haley Steinfeld.
Who the fuck is that?
Sounds like a girl you went to high school with.
Who the fuck is Steinfeld? I like a quiet room full of people here, so they go, wait a second.
That must be.
Is this Haley Steinfeld's new stuff? I recognize that voice.
I could name this. I could name the song in two notes. This is Haley Steinfeld.
If you're allowed only one app on your phone, what app would you choose? Music for iPhone. She answers like a fucking Frankenstein monster. Music for iPhone.
Me, dance.
Pinterest for activities.
Oh,
Jessica
God.
Looks attainable.
I love it. She is hot.
Oh, she went to China and went to All-Star Weekend. Her favorite movie is ATL, starring T.I.
What? Please play the trailer for ATL, because I want to know that this, out of all the movies.
All movies. This is the most general question they've offered these dimwits.
This is the only one.
By the way, I might be back in, because if she had to vote for the best food on Earth... Chick-fil-A.
Yeah, so you know she's down for maybe a spicy sandwich.
She's down for a little Chick-fil-A. She's going to grunt out a heater in my room the next morning.
And maybe go home and watch ATL. Do you have ATL on DVD?
The TI movie. Oh, my God. Let's invite her to a private screening of ATL.
Are you talking about the TI movie? I thought that was a music video the first time I saw it. Is this it?
No, it's coming. Yeah, the ATL trailer.
Sherrod's doing commercials now, huh?
Fantastic. Oh, I didn't realize Sherrod and Kenan Thompson had a kid.
Today, we're going to be talking about choice.
Pause it. There's something
What's
playing
happening
in the
background.
There's something on...
Really wanna...
Our motto, Sigurd, was true to what we do, and we say true to us.
What the fuck?
A turning point.
Oh, you have Sports Center up? Yeah, I was like, oh, God, Ashley's, oh, God, their boyfriend showed up.
Part of the game, young buck.
Man, you ain't nobody's dad.
I'm trying to make it out.
Y'all slackers better figure out what y'all gonna do.
I guess you just gonna fake it till you make it, huh?
Let's slow it down a little bit.
In the ATL.
I never feel comfortable on this side of town. Man, kind of how I feel about
all this question answered is what kind of dick she's looking for in life.
Yeah, so let's... Just
gonna have to wait. This is the movie that fucking...
all wanted one thing.
This is the movie that Joel Embiid played for before he dicked her down this offseason.
Yeah, he's like, this is what you
watch.
This
you want to come over my place and watch ATL?
That's my favorite movie.
Oh, that's cool. We can just kick it.
You've got talent.
You know about that.
I wish you could see what I see.
His town is roller skating, by the way, for the record.
Take a ride with your boy.
Come on.
You've been lying about where you've been going and who you've been with.
You special.
Special, huh?
Leave me. I'm going to make it, and I won't forget where I come from.
You know, we can get off this. We can go back to the questions, because I just want to say, whatever it is, If they ask you what your favorite movie in the world is, and it's anything that stars first billed T.I.
I mean, I almost wanted
you to... You are a world-class boob.
I wanted to go with her on this because I do love the movie Belly. No joke.
Is it... Would it, if you were... even in a crunch, if you were like, you don't have a lot of time to answer, would that even be in your first 15 thoughts?
No. No. No fucking... No singer movie.
I mean, it's so hilarious.
I love Elvis Does Hawaii.
What's your favorite movie? Really quick. Tokyo Drift. Fast Furious 3. Anything with Lil Bow Wow.
Baby Boy. Starring Tyrese and Snoop Dogg.
Like Mike. Her favorite television show, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. That's just playing to the crowd. Her favorite book she's ever read, Five People You Meet in Heaven. I don't know what that is. If she went into a quiet room, now here we are. Let's do it again.
Okay.
Here's how we always do it. If you walk into a quiet room full of people, what's the song you would choose to play? Hey, it sure is quiet in here. I wish someone would break the tension with maybe a good song.
This is a good cocktail party, but I'm glad there's no music. Wait, who's that?
Yeah.
Oh, is that Jessica walking in?
I know we just signed the deal, but...
Ooh!
I need my advance on the next one, too.
I love that one of them was overjoyed by Stevie Wonder, and the rest of these fucking half-wits just always have like a... Oh, something with a fresh, chunky beat.
I'd be embarrassed. I'd be like, Dan, is that your girlfriend coming into this? You're like, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, it is.
My whole family, bump it.
Dan, where's your new girlfriend, Jessica? Is she
here? That's her.
She's coming over.
Wait, yeah, Lou, cut it.
Guys, I actually need everybody to be quiet or she won't come in the room yet.
Guys, thank you very much for coming to my engagement party. I know you haven't met her, but God, if I'm excited for you not to.
It means a lot to me for you all to be here. Christ.
Mom? Nana, you're here. All the cousins.
Dan, where is this girl?
Nana, hold on.
I came here a long way.
I know. Hold on. She's going to come in the room right now. All right, guys, I want you to meet my fiance, Jessica.
Yeah.
I know. Dan, we're all getting uncomfortable.
I know. Just she's going to wait till the beat kicks in like a prize fighter.
Dan, she's not going to be one of those blacks, is she?
No, Mom, she's white.
What's up, motherfuckers? Hey, y'all. I mean, Jessica. Bump it. Grab it. Pop it. Fuck it. I suck this dick during ATL. Yeah, boy. I love a sense of community and pride in Philadelphia.
Better not have some Chick-fil-A or I will fuck shit.
Chick-fil-A, yo, that's the kid, yo.
All right, y'all. Y'all got to throw out the wedding invitations now. Y'all want spicy chicken or y'all want regular?
We have a Chick-fil-A at the wedding.
If you say no pickles, you can get the fuck out. You know what's up.
People want to know.
Oh, this is a new Sixers dancer.
Oh, Nicolette looks like a girl I would leave comedy for.
Yeah.
I'm in love with her.
The Sixers beat
call
match.
Her dumb, I will fly over this couch and attack you.
She can't live without music, that's fair.
All right, cool.
Her favorite movie, Step Up.
Okay.
You know what? Guys, at very least, it's Step Up 1.
Hey, you know what?
I thought she was going to throw another sequest. Huh?
It's very on brand. She's a dancer.
I don't hate this one. Look, her favorite television show is So You Think You Can Dance.
Okay, it's keeping in a theme. I'm in love with Nicolette.
The best food on earth, broader spectrum. She says Italian.
Great.
Okay, I'm okay with that. Could be northern, could be southern.
I think we're finding my
could be heavy
girl.
In carbs, could be heavy in meats.
What's her favorite
white
book?
White sauces, dark sauces. Favorite book, The Best of Me. That's
sounds
smarter
up.
Than me. I'm unaware of it.
Okay.
And then if you walk into a quiet room, hang on. Here we
wait,
go.
Can I reintroduce her to my family now that
please,
I'm in love?
No, it's always got to be a different quiet room. He goes, everyone, he goes, I traveled a long way to be here. He goes, it's very uncomfortable. I knew when Pop was dying that this was going to be a very difficult day. And I know none of you guys have met Nicolette yet, but I'd like to introduce her to you. Now, Nana, are you okay? Are you okay? I know Pop.
I miss my husband.
I know. But everyone, if you could, please, Nicolette.
Where's your girlfriend?
Nicolette coming out. I know you're gonna love her.
Okay! Is this a funeral or a party?
Nicolette, I'm gonna be at the Helium Comedy Club in Philadelphia. December 20th, at the end of the month for New Year's. If you don't have a boyfriend, please come out here.
In fact, you are gonna be there. Thursday, December 29th through New Year's Eve. Saturday, December 31st. Get your tickets at heliumcomedy.com.
But sooner than that, Big J this weekend going to be a parlor
live in Seattle.
It's gonna be a suds party in Seattle. Everyone in the office is looking at us. Fuck you.
Why is everybody who works here like a fucking tow truck driver? Who's that squarehead? Yeah. Looks like Merkface ate Mike Vecchione.
We take another break. Come back with more Philly girls.
We're gonna go through the rest of these. Chicks,
I mean, good luck usurping Nicolette.
Oh, we'll find her. I got good high hopes about Nicole and Rachel. We got
Nicolette's number one.
She's your number one. She's not
Ichiban.
Mine.
Ichiban.
Let's go jerk it out over a break. It's the Bonfire.
Slap dicks.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soder.
I need yes, indeed.
It is the Bonfire. We are back. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Big J. Oakerson, Dan Soder. We are listening to some Rodney Carrington hits all day. This guy, the guy outside this office, is ripping me to shreds with laughter.
He's a bigger fella with a no neck. His head goes right into his body, and Jay.
He's doing a lot of sitting on the desk talking to somebody.
Just
is he
made
a girl
me
he's
laugh.
Talking to? Murkfist, you check him out.
That's a guy.
He's talking to a guy?
And he... Oh, my God.
He really is. He's such a squat human being.
You called him...
Ram Man. He looks like Ram Man.
I wanted you to do the actual joke that you said
he's
to me.
A human,
yeah. We're just doing that. He looks like an East Coast Goomba.
Hey, guys. If I'm not at work next week, it's because I got cast as Ram Man in Masters of the Universe on Broadway. It's a musical. It's also. I wish you could see him doing things.
Mattel is
right over there. Right over there on Broadway. Sorry. Yeah.
He looks like an old titan of industry from like the 50s, where they're like, "That's the Steel Baron."
He looks like like whatever Hobbit would carry a giant battle axe.
he looks exactly like that. Oh God!
Look, back to prettier things.
Prettier, dumber thing. So here's the thing. We all know that I'm in love with Nicolette of the Sixers dancers. Nikki, you know it. I know it. Let's just be together. But now we're picking our other...
You guys are totally going to fox when you go down to...
Well, we're going through the list of Sixers dancers.
She's
going
to be your New Year's Eve fan.
Dude, don't even put that in my head. What's happening. What a lovely kiss.
In my mind, it's already happening. They're big Bonfire fans.
What a lovely kiss that would be. What a soft, sensual... I probably just covered by her lower back. I'd be very respectful. Don't even do that. Not with Nicolette. Let's move on. Have we done Amanda yet?
We have not done Brianna.
Well, we got to start moving alphabetically. This is Amanda.
We'll start moving up. Amanda. All right, Amanda's got some sweet moose knuckle. Holy shit, that is rammed up there. Favorite television show, The Walking Dead.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
What? Oh, my God. They are, they're children. They're all just dumb
children. She can't live without them. She's a recreational therapist? Is that something you should do?
I think that's highly dangerous.
I think that's not okay.
Tell me your problems.
I'm a psychologist. Hobby more than anything else. But so you're thinking of killing yourself. That sounds pretty weak.
That sucks. But also be strong.
Have you thought about listening to You Making My Dreams Come True by Haunters?
You're going to give away the song. We have to have him walk into it.
Oh, we got to not announce what the song is until we have him walk in?
Yeah.
You're right. It's a way better idea. My apologies.
And then,
Christine, great news. We can get pizza tonight because Amanda's favorite food is pizza. So we're good. No, you're good, though. No, Christine, look at me. You're fine. You look just like that. Yes, you do. I wouldn't be with you if you didn't.
I love her favorite movie. It all comes... Sometimes that's what just takes the air out of all of it. Is when you're like, oh, you are a simple person.
Wreck-It Ralph, she goes, I don't understand when people act.
I like when computers act. I know when they're being emotional, but people can lie. And computers can't because they're programmed.
I get scared until... Drawings talk.
If drawings talk and music is there, I'm happy.
Her favorite thing about Philadelphia is attending pop-up events.
Wow, all right.
What the hell that even means?
Yeah, the bar's pretty set pretty low on that one. This is odd.
Hey, we're having boner wars down in
Did you guys hear there's another pop-up event?
Who's the girl that loves ATL? She's like, I don't care. I'm trying to get this black dick.
Yo, I don't give a shit about that. Yo, I'm getting my grill fitted tonight.
I'm sitting in this snake pit of black dick.
It's like my favorite movie, Anaconda 2, Blood Diamonds.
I love all of it.
So what's the next walking into thing? What are they walking into now? We've done a funeral.
Well, as you know, the co-op board can't approve everyone. But this is old Philadelphia. This is Old Town off Walnut Street. One of the highest grossing condominiums ever. This is our next person who's applying, and she said that she would like to enter the room to music to let the co-op board know exactly what kind of person she is. So,
here.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present our possible new tenant, Amanda. Did we just become best friends?
I think we did. I love this chick now.
Yeah.
Amanda wasn't even
and by the way, she's my favorite
hottest.
What I want.
Maybe laugh so hard.
I love it.
This is not my top 20 favorite Hall & Oates songs, but
you know what though? As far as walking into a room, it's a good one.
It made her hotter. Bet one of the best books, another child's book, The Hunger Games. But here's the thing about a man. Now I want to say, I'm going to preface this before we even move on.
Towards a shed.
None of these girls. Get out of here, Amanda.
Get your ass back
to East Brunswick, New Jersey.
Yeah, go back to fucking Rutgers.
Here's the thing about Amanda. First of all, I hope somehow we can get word to these girls. We're doing a whole show about them. So I'd like to say, as we're going to continue to call you all.
We're going to continue
to call you all dumb and all kinds of shit. However, none of you would. I can't speak for Dan.
None of you would fuck me
on my best day.
None of them would fuck me either.
You're all far too hot for me in any chance. And the only chance I'd have of getting you is if Christine somehow convinced you she'd lick your butthole while a fat guy jerks off over your forehead. Which is what she's good at. But I'm just saying, my point is like, so we're going to take shots, but they're all hot chicks.
I mean, they're fucking NBA dancers.
They're an NBA dance team. Christine, say fucking cheerleader. I'm throwing the rest of my chai at you. Let's get
what a cheerleader move to throw chai.
Amanda, but Amanda wasn't what I would say is the hottest type to me out of the game. I'm not a big blondes guy.
Me neither. So she's not your number one.
She's not my number one.
Is Amanda anyone in here's number one?
No.
All right, move on.
Somebody's already picked a number. Jacob's got a number one, which is who?
Jessica.
Who's Jessica? Go to Jessica.
This one.
Oh, Jessica.
The dumbest.
Oh, let me tell you right now. You have no shot.
When I come back and watch Fresh Prince of Bel-Air at my place?
Hooded sweatshirt I could borrow?
You want to share?
It's pretty cold in your apartment. She goes, hold on, my ex-boyfriend left something.
Double XL Jordan hoodie.
You want to have some Chick-fil-A and then we'll go jog 6 miles to get rid of it?
I don't want it to stick.
Hey, you want a couple's puke after we eat?
Who's better, Drake or Future? Trick question. They're both great.
Especially when they collabo on some hot beats like Big Rings.
To me, nothing's better than reading 5 People You Met in Heaven, bumping some Drake and Future.
I don't think these girls are understanding of what they mean when you can only have one app on your phone, because she chose mail.
Yeah, that's a function, right?
She chose to have email.
They're all picking functions of smartphones. Yeah. Apps are extracurricular shit, like Instagram,
Angry
Twitter.
Birds.
Yeah.
Even. Or, you know.
Even like a Maps.
Yeah, if one of them says flashlight, because I'm always losing my that one I will fuck.
Because you got a shot. All right, this is Brianna, smoking hot.
Black chick in Philly. She is not fucking me. She can't live without her iPhone. She is from Newark, Delaware. Her favorite thing was dancing at the University of Arts.
I love that they always amend the question to their answers, because one girl was like, with every other girl it's been, what's your favorite app you can't live without? And everyone said one, and one girl goes, Twitter and Instagram. And they're like, all right, we'll change the goddamn question.
No,
we'll change it to shows. No, I'm telling you, the other one, they change it to apps. They change it.
Oh, show. She has two shows. Yeah, but the apps thing is still there.
Oh,
that's number 10.
No, but I'm saying they. Oh, okay. They did.
But television shows is a different thing. Her favorite movie is Love and Basketball, which is just hilarious.
But you know what? I'll give it to her.
It's in her world.
I give it to her. It's on point. It's as the
if a comic said his favorite movie was Funny People, I'd say one, he's a liar, and two, I'd say like okay, but I get what you're doing.
Yeah,
I get what you're doing.
If it's just a punchline.
Comedy or punchline is one of my favorite movies of all time. It's so ridiculous. I'm still waiting to get my comedy locker.
Yeah, oh God, I would love to have lockers.
Her favorite television shows: Scandal and Grey's Anatomy.
Okay.
Look, we're not going to watch TV together at any point.
Now, what do you think of her favorite food?
I'm okay with this. Pretzels. Yeah. I'm a big pretzel guy.
So, I mean, that's...
I love pretzels. Oh, my God. Put pretzel sticks right in my pee hole for her.
All right. There we go. Is she getting near the top of the list for you?
The best book she's ever... You know what we should have done here, too, which we could have fun with when we start doing it now? The best book she's ever read, Fly Girl. Can we look up the synopsis of some of these books that we don't know?
Yeah. The second you see a book, Christina, I want you to look up the synopsis of what these books are about. Ones that aren't based on movies, of course, like The Five People You Meet in Heaven and Fly Girl. Which, please let it be about a woman that gets mixed with a fly, like the Jeff Goldblum classic movie, The Fly. It's not. Oh, you found it.
Yeah.
What's it about, Murkface? Here. Get Murkface on a mic. You can stand up, you know.
Nah. It's a novella for young adults about an African American woman who
becomes a Sixers dancer.
Joins the women's Air Force.
She wrote it.
She's like, fly girl.
Who joins the WASP, the Women's Air Force Service Pilots.
Oh, Tuskegee
during
shit.
World War II.
Okay.
It examines themes of racial and gender identity in America.
Good for her. Good for her.
It's short.
Brianna, you're getting near the top of my list.
It's...
Nicolette's got it.
Available on Barnes & Noble for $5.62 on paperback.
Which one? Oh, there's two Fly Girls. There's another Fly Girl with two Ys. Please check the synopsis.
I hope it's that one.
Because this one's actually...
By the way, it's Fly Girl with a space is the difference. You say this is the one.
I disagree.
Tracy Ellison, A Young Knockout.
The best-selling urban classic novel about a young woman coming of age in the late 80s.
Okay.
A Young Knockout with tall hair and attitude is living life.
Neither one of these are bad. Again, they're not based on movies that have came out in the last four years.
I'm okay with that.
I'm okay with this. Brianna.
Keep this up. Brianna.
You are a strong contender for my number one, but I still got to go with my girl Nicolette.
Now, do I bring her into her song?
Oh, yeah. You got to. What's the new one?
You got it ready, Lou? Yeah, I got ready? Okay, here we go. It goes, all right, Cheryl, girls, you know I brought you together, because guess what? I'm pregnant again.
Congratulations!
Yeah, that's right. We got artificially inseminated. I want y'all to meet my new girlfriend.
Okay, that's very progressive of us.
It's very progressive. We're getting ready to do this, but she fly. She mad fly.
She a fly girl.
Oh, she a mad fly girl. Oh, that's it. You ever read Fly Girl? That's a good novella.
I read both of them all the time.
That shit about Dub Dub 2, yo.
Yeah, I like that one, and I like the one about the woman taking her on and making her own sexual attraction her own.
Yeah, that shit from about the 80s with the girl with the tall hair. Okay, anyway, here she is, y'all. I want you to welcome my new girlfriend. You better treat her like family, y'all. You better treat her like family, because we be eating each other's pussies all day. Brianna, get in here, yo.
Oh,
this bitch fly.
This is some rad shit. VRE, yeah. Brianna, you haven't, I don't know. I'm really torn in between Nicolette and Brianna.
Brianna's nice.
Yeah, Murkface isn't having it.
Yeah, well, she's not going to fuck up. And one thing she loves about Philly, there's always something to do. All right, here we go, Chelsea. Now, this was a sleeper pick for you, Dan.
Oh!
Yeah, she does not... Biloxi, Missouri. She's going to make a pilgrimage to become a Sixers dancer. It was her dream.
I woke up and I said, dance for the Sixers.
When she's not dancing, she's a dance instructor.
Okay.
Well, that's better than hobby
therapist.
Mental health work.
I'm a hobby therapist.
I do a little hobby. I dabble in some mental health work.
I usually like to bring up people's past traumas and just get them all geeked up, and then I leave because it's only a hobby.
Okay. Here's something she can't live without: her mom.
And well, she's going to have to.
And she's going to eventually one day. She just goes, nope, that's the day I kill myself.
I end it.
Now,
Japanese.
Her favorite movie, Moulin Rouge. Not angry about that. Don't agree. Not angry about it.
Not angry.
Favorite television show, Golden Girls. Not angry about that at all.
That's actually a good pick.
It's a pretty good pick.
And by the way, I watch it with my grandma whenever I visit her, which, we talked about on Monday. Still, it's a well-written show. Very well-written sitcom.
Very funny. If she had to pick her favorite food on Earth, mashed potatoes, that's pretty dumb.
Yeah, or did you come here in steerage from Europe?
If I could have one thing in the world, it would be a hot potato with a little bit of butter on it.
Best
mashed
book.
Into a bowl.
Best book she's read, Frankenstein.
Mary Shelley's? Because, I mean, that's some legit shit. That's a real look at human nature versus God. I mean, that's a lot of stuff.
I'll be honest with you. This chick isn't even in my top 10 on this board of looks. I swear to you, of looks.
Yeah.
I love her answers on almost everything.
What's her next answer for if you're allowed one app on your phone?
Pandora.
Okay, great.
It's an app.
It is
makes
an app.
Sense.
But what does she love most?
I'm a Spotify man, but I'm not going to make it a whole thing.
What does she love about Philly?
It's history.
Put her on the team. Put her on the trivia team. She's on
the trivia team. And Dan?
Yeah.
Give her a little intro. This is your new chick walking into your life.
It's the end of the third quarter. As you know, profits have been low. So I have brought in a new CFO. Again, we like to take strides here. So I want to introduce to you our new CFO, Chelsea.
This is my song, and this one's for you.
What a somber moment.
Also, you all have AIDS.
Everyone, congratulations. You've all just been given AIDS.
You have advanced.
Did everybody enjoy their coffee? Because it was laced with AIDS.
You all have advanced AIDS.
You have stage 8 AIDS. Okay, moving on.
Is she your number one?
Answers wise.
The door is shut every time. The music.
Answer, we can't go with this. We already saw this one.
Davina,
we
go next. Yeah.
Now, Jamila looks like a Somalian boat pirate.
No, she does not. She's fucking hot.
What?
Are you kidding me? She's crazy hot.
She is.
Am I the only one that thinks she's hot?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was looking at my own reflection in her giant forehead.
Hey, shut up. Some of us have big foreheads.
This girl's not going to fuck me anyway. I can see all the things I want. She's from Atlantic City, though, so I'm not going to fuck with her. That's gangster.
Yeah, that is gangster shit.
No, she's smoking fucking hot, obviously. But she is really thin and really muscly.
But look at this. When she's
I don't personally go for the... Look, she probably doesn't go for fat whites. So I don't go for bony, muscular, thin blacks.
That'd be great if that was actually her thing.
Into fat whites.
If I would describe my perfect man, number one, I'd have to say husky, white, husky, Caucasian. I love husky Caucasian. She said when she's not dancing, she's an occupational therapy student, so much safer.
And a pure barre.
Pure barre is like exercise.
Oh, okay.
NBA All-Star Weekend 2015. She's specific.
Her favorite memory.
She lets you know what it is. Is there anything that you can't absolutely live without?
Her email.
I mean, that's, she's business. Fair. All right, her favorite movie. Now, we've gotten a lot of children answers, but this is one that I feel is kind of okay.
I'm okay with this, yeah.
Her favorite movie is The Lion King.
That's fine.
Okay. It's old enough.
It came out when I was young.
You've never seen The Lion King, Merc Face? No.
What? You are empty.
That's why he can smoke so many civilians overseas with his AR-15.
Now, here's where I get a little scared. I'm not going to lie.
All right.
Favorite television shows. Empire, whatever.
Yeah.
I'm fine with that. I Had to Get Away with Murder.
A lot of people like it. Very critically acclaimed.
But a crazy black dancer chick who's into occupational therapy and cartoons. Yeah, I don't want that. That makes me nervous.
I like it. I'll tell you this right now. She's bumped Brianna for number two.
Second answer, by the way, for this, what's your favorite food, best food on earth? Anything with buffalo chicken.
Love her.
That's good.
Love her.
Best book she's ever read.
The Giver.
Giver.
You know what? That's a good book. Christine just made an awe face. She wasn't by a mic.
Yeah.
And also, what a great thing that you want in a sexual partner. Is a giver.
And someone who's willing to try to find out how to get away with murder.
Yes, absolutely.
Second time she answers about, she really wants to hammer home, she's really about her email. Because it's all, she can't live without her email, and it's also the only app on her phone she would have if she can only have one.
She needs her email. She needs multiple emails. I get it. She's busy.
She loves Bet Philly.
She's a student. She's working for the Sixers. She's got a lot going on.
She loves Bet Philly is that there's always something to do until 2 a.m.
And then everything shuts down.
And then it's all shut down. Then it gets very terrifying. Very dangerous.
Yeah, so I was just going to say, after 2 a.m., it does get incredibly terrifying. All right, you want to introduce her into her song?
I will. He goes, well, how's it looking, Chief? He goes, well, we got two bodies on the ground. One's still breathing. We're rushing him over to the hospital. But this scene, we had to call in our specialist, the new girl. Get her in. Send her over. This is Agent Jamila, everybody.
As she saunters into the room.
I want you to breathe me. Let me be your air.
I'm on board with this.
No, you're not.
I'm on board.
You are starting to be. You are trying so hard to be politically correct.
No, I'm not trying to be politically correct. She bumps Brianna for my number two. Nicolette's number one.
Dude, this is the song. If she walked in the room, the song she wants to find her is a new song by Calvin Harris.
I like it. It's not goofy like the other ones.
You're pretty sure this is the girl you're gonna fuck on New Year's Eve?
No way, but that'd be great.
You're trying. Also, looks like her belly button goes to her tits.
Do they say nice pants? Why do they go right to her
tits? They say nice pants.
Now,
Julie looks like we can all fuck. Julie looks like her other... Oh, by the way, I swear to God, I was gonna go, she looks like a goddamn kindergarten teacher. When I'm not dancing, I am a first grade teacher.
She's been on the squad 5 years, though.
Oh, my God. She is very able to be met.
Can I tell you, I think this is Merkface's next girlfriend.
Absolutely.
Is there anything in the world you can't live without? Can't live without her family.
Oh, Christine's going to dive headfirst into this girl's box. Favorite movie, Clueless.
Boom.
Favorite television show, Friends. This is Christine. Favorite food, nachos. That's close. You like nachos.
You like them, though, too.
I was so excited. All right, let's. What's this dumb book? What was the book on the Somali bow pirate? Oh, The Giver.
The Giver.
The Giver is.
Yeah, it was The Giver.
I know.
Jamila.
Let's see Joey's dumb book.
It is...
Something borrowed.
Which sounds like something that definitely makes you cry.
Is this something you read in front of a circle full of children?
What do you love most about Philadelphia? The Walnut Street Shopping. Mitchell and Ness, get geared up.
Hey, bitch. I'm
going
to get me a new hat and a new jean jacket.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, she looks... If you saw her on the street and she was like, I'm a Sixers dancer, you'd be like, you were?
You go... You tried out for them?
You're a fan of theirs? Yeah,
when I don't get it, like, at halftime, when they let, like, people come on and dance, or... Wait, what happened?
Sorry, I was grading papers on everybody. What are we doing? That Calvin Harris song again?
Jamila Pickett?
Oh, Jesus Christ, is Jamila Pickett again? All right, here.
Something borrowed by Emily Griffin.
Rachel,
by Emily Giffen.
Rachel White is a consummate good girl, a hardworking attorney at a large Manhattan.
It was made into a movie.
Was it
made into a movie? It's a Kate Hudson movie.
Ah, Christ.
Shit. Hell. You had to pick a damn movie. I told her not to pick it, and she didn't want it. She didn't want it. I said, no, pick a movie.
Nick Nolte's doing the question asking.
What's your favorite movie? Come with the same thing as the actor. You can't live with it. All your girls are picking damn movies based
how
on
much of a How much of a raging...
You're all picking mine.
How much of a raging See You Next Tuesday... I'm not going to curse in front of a teacher.
Yeah.
How much of a raging See You Next Tuesday must Jamila feel like when it's like, is there anything you absolutely can't live without? She says, email, and then reiterates later, I said my mail. And this girl answers, what you can't live without is my family. And you go, oh, we could have said family. I don't know, we could have said family.
I'm in family. Then mail.
Oh, what do you mean? What do you mean no take backseat? Now look like a dumbass.
You can't take it back. We tried to get. She tried to give back the second Gmail answer. He didn't want it.
Because by the way, her app is Instagram, and she didn't go. What can you not live without? Instagram. And what's the only app you want to have? I said Instagram.
Stop taking down my number two.
She said my family and Instagram, respectively.
All right.
Listen, if I just told you, we asked them two questions. Their answers were my family and Instagram, yeah, and the other person's were email and email.
I'd be like, that's a businesswoman.
You'd be like, that chick sucks.
I'd be like, that's a businesswoman. Get her shit done. I like it. Business before family.
Oh, my God.
You want me to introduce her to her new song?
I'd like that.
What's her name again? Julie?
It's Julie.
As you all know, we had to let go of Mrs. Fredrickson for having sex with two students. But I promise you, our next teacher will not have sex with any of the students. Please welcome Julie. You just shut it down that quick? This is like music I'd get mad at my girlfriend for playing while I was driving. Like, can we go to another song we both like?
This fucking sucks.
I understand it's Beyonce, but can we please go to a song we both can do?
Julie, maybe your stupid fuckhead first grade Philadelphia students want to hear this shit, but I don't.
Oh, okay.
Now maybe Katie may have just pulled in. She's thick.
Yeah, I like Katie. She's like from Worcester, Mass. Yeah. Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah. You guys like the fucking Sixers?
It looks like she kisses bad.
I fucking got a lot of hard tongue. If you fucking open your mouth, I'm going to jam my tongue right in it.
I'm really hot, but my feet stink.
Yeah. Well, I've been a Sixers dancer for 4 years. The Celtics wouldn't. They said I couldn't be a dancer for the Celtics because I kept yelling the N-word at all the players. apparently, it's not frowned down upon.
Let's
here in
go,
Philadelphia.
Spookies. Yeah. Oh, come on. You know it's funny.
Ah, fucking Jessica loves them, but I fucking egg it.
Let's go, moon crickets. Come on. They don't even know what that one means with the little brains.
Honestly, I can't live with.
Okay, her answer to me, yeah. This is another one where she just feels bad. She can't live without her family.
That's yeah. Another one. And she's not dancing, she's an HR coordinator.
HR, the coordinator.
Favorite movie, Dirty Dancing. I'm not upset about that.
Her favorite television show.
The Real Housewives. Oof. And here's what I'm telling you, I'm not upset about that. If she's thinking on the fly, it's because there's a lot of fighting in it. I love the Bad Girls Club, dude. It might
yes,
be my answer for that question. If you had to vote for the best food on earth, what food would you choose? Now, here's someone who's self-conscious about their weight. Here's what the thickest girl finally gives an answer. Sweet potato fries. She goes, well, I mean, everyone else does kind of fattening food, but I'm going to do like the healthiest of the fattening foods.
Oh, dude. I'm sorry. I read her book answer, and I thought of something, and it made me spit take on my own thought. But I just, they keep answering. Her favorite book is...
Again, Divergent.
So I keep thinking about all of these girls... Like wearing reading glasses and finishing Divergent. Going this.
Wow. That was. I really thought about. Like.
It's going to be a lot to talk about water court HR coordination tomorrow.
I just always think all these dum dums being blown away by Divergent where they're like, wow, it's really good.
That's. Well, now her fucking song sucks.
Wait, to walk into?
Because it's. Not a specific song. We'll just give the
answer.
Well,
Lou gets to pick one.
All right.
Lou likes this.
Oh, do the we got to start last week, if you remember.
Ben?
Yeah.
You going to walk her in?
Yeah. Hey, everyone. We have to do some major layoffs, and I can't tell you which of you it's going to be. It's a random selection. Don't take any of this personal. Coming in to do these... Very, very difficult decisions is our new head of HR coordination, everybody. Katie. Katie, please.
The two of us need no more.
I mean, she said anything.
She said anything about Michael Jackson. You want to bring the whole room? By the way, if you think that girl doesn't have her dancer shorts crammed up her sniz hole, then you guys are blind.
She's from fucking Worcester. They fucking go high up there. Fuck you. These fucking shorts are wicked tight.
I do a headstand and my boyfriend comes in and karate chops my box.
You can fucking have a glass of juice from with the pants resting when I do a handstand.
Her favorite app, MapQuest, which is weird.
Outdated?
Because MapQuest isn't... I don't even think there's an app for MapQuest.
Oh my God. Katie, I can't wait to blow your mind and show you Google Maps.
Holy fucking shit.
Oh, my my God, is this the fucking future?
Is that the
building I'm in?
My clock's like a flip phone?
Oh, fuck this. I usually had to go to MapQuest.com and type in everything I wanted.
All right, we looked at Carrie earlier. Is there anything about I want to do her song, though, yeah. Because we found out most of everything about her. She's a healthcare administrator, besides, which is like they all seem to be.
And, of course, Twilight Talk.
She is... Now, again, not my thing, and like blonde hair, blue eyes, but I mean, she's just, you can't, undeniably, you're like, this is a fucking smoking hot chick.
Do you want me to do her song?
Oh, yes, you have to. Her favorite movie's Rudy, her favorite show, Sex in the City, favorite food, pasta, Twilight Zone.
Her name's Kate. Katie?
Her name's Kate.
Carrie.
Well, she always unnecessarily is blanking out the names for us. She doesn't want me to remember them so I can look them up on... She doesn't want me to look them up on the gram later.
On the gram. Find them up on the gram. Hit them up.
Or MapQuest.com.
Easily. One of the hardest parts of being a doctor that works with children with cancer is seeing their tiny faces when I tell them there is no hope. Well, I'd like to introduce you to my new nurse. It's pretty tough.
The Patch Adams.
She's going to cheer everyone up with a little bit of dancing. I'd like to welcome everybody, Nurse Carrie. Carrie, come in.
There she is.
That's right. It's all the cancer's deep in all of your bones. But Carrie's going to dance until you feel all right. Couldn't get the rock. He's too busy.
It's so malignant, I can't even tell you.
Honestly, I feel uncomfortable that none of you are wearing face masks. I don't want you to breathe in any sort of poison.
If we had a barrel full of marrow, we couldn't save you.
Seriously, I thought about that too, naming my company Barrel of Marrow.
Natasha, I want to say, is going to be one of my faves.
All right, let's move on. Ooh, we've already done Natasha.
Yeah, we did Natasha.
What about Michelle? We did Michelle? Michelle, yeah. Nikki!
Yes.
Okay. Oh, man.
Oh, God, her song is...
It's going to be really great. I mean, like, it's the one song you'd want to play in your world. Oh, my God. Okay.
She
studies dance at the University of Art, so we did go through this already.
And she really can't live without dancing.
She can't live without dancing. Her family, fuck them. Her favorite movie, We're the Millers, offshoot of a Jason Sudeikis and Jennifer Aniston's side work.
What's your favorite movie of all time? Is it a Paul Thomas Anderson? Is it anything by Tarantino? The Coen Brothers? How about the Jason Sudeikis vehicle? We're the Millers.
We're the Millers was one of those movies where it was like we had to get rid of that last picture of the third picture deal.
Yeah, it is such an airplane movie.
Of course.
It is the airplane movie.
Well, I saw it when I went on my first airplane.
I went on a Fly, and then I saw the guy from SNL, and it was Rachel from Friends. And it's I don't think Rachel's name is Rachel Miller in the show, but it should have been because it makes a lot more sense.
All right, let's see what the rest of her... she's the one, their favorite food ever is quesadillas. Fault in Our Stars is the best book, which is also a movie. Also weirdly about cancer.
Yeah.
The Gram is what the app she wants. She loves all the art in the city.
Are these girls all Westworld robots that were programmed in the last 5 years where they're like, we can only show her recent movies?
She may, looks-wise, be my favorite one so far, though.
Yeah. Murkface says so far, and so does Jacob.
I like that crazy long hair she has.
Y'all can suck a dick. Really Nicolette's pretty. Number one in my heart and in my mind. Now, Jay, please introduce her fucking song.
Hey, Mom, listen, I know you guys really like Christine, but she died. And at the funeral, I met this really cool chick who was there to dance to cheer up the kids. And, you know, I'm going to stop talking about her. Let's just bring her in. Hey, Nick, hon.
Omarion.
Okay, man.
I love the first words. Omarion. Oh, but right now my mom and Joe are both up doing fucking... That's nice. Your girlfriend, Foyne. All right,
Her vibing, just at a sunset looking at this.
The song's called Post to Be. Oh my God. Is this song called Post to Be?
Yeah, Post to Be.
Oh my God.
Nicole looks intense. Hey, what's up? You want to come on my show?
Where do you want to rail it, man? You want to go shitter or fucking.
We got 6 minutes.
Right in the T-Watt tonight. You going to the T-Watt?
Get him up and get him hard. You got about 6 minutes.
Blow it on my back. Watch, I'll flex up and make it run to my shoulders.
If I lock my traps, it rolls off like a duck's back.
Oh, shit.
All right.
Well, she's an accountant when she's not dancing.
Just crunching.
And a man.
Yeah.
I'm a male accountant during the day. And then at nighttime, I really got to cut loose.
Fun dude. Oh.
First half hour of every game, I spend tucking my dong between my cheeks.
Well, she can't live without.
Hey, girls. Any of you guys? Hey, Nicolette, you want to come in here and tape down my dork?
Hey, I need you to work back end today. I need you to tape the head and pull back like you're about to launch me out of a catapult. And then snap it up on my lower back.
Hey, anybody want to tie off my hose before we go out there?
Yeah.
I don't want any accidents happen during our song.
If you're allowed to live with one app on your phone, which app would you choose? Notes. She's making a lot of notes.
What is this?
She's making a lot of notes on her phone.
Where does she say this?
Number 10, dude.
Her app, yeah. The Philadelphia Scarlet Knight. Is she the second girl? Is it the second girl to have this fucking, that same exact Calvin Harris song?
Yep. So also, we're not even going to introduce her.
Also
I
loves,
don't even want to do that.
Well, I want to give the rest of her loves.
Well, she's also the second girl that says.
What's her favorite food? Carbs. Proteins.
Heavy. I like whey protein. Is that a food? I want whey protein.
Any pot. Yeah. If any food ever lures you. Creatine.
Tiger milk. Number one. Tiger milk.
Any one food in the world? Rare steak. I don't need a fork. What am I, a faggot?
I'll grill it on my abs. Oh, God. And she's also in the book club that loves Divergent that also closed it and put it down and went.
She is not original. It. Okay, now I'm just looking at another thing.
Who is
I
this?
I think I may love. Christine, will you let me see her name? I'll find her later anyway.
Rachel. This is Rachel.
Oh, God. When she's
I know
dancing.
I know that people are listening, like, are you guys going to go through all of the dancers? And that answer is, yeah, we are.
We're almost done.
How do you not know that we're going to do that on this show? This is what we do.
And so her favorite memory is also dancing in China. She's a recruiter for an IT staffing company.
She can't live without coffee and music.
I'm okay with that. Her favorite movie is Cars.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, that's a little childish for her age.
She's like,
but cars don't talk, and then the cars can talk, and then the cars shouldn't talk, but they're friends, and the truck is really nice, but he's kind of dumb, and the race car just wants to do really good.
Is the one where her favorite food is cookies?
Yeah.
Her favorite book is Adam Sandler's The Longest Yard.
No, they were,
she read the script for it.
She's like, I love the original take starring
Burt Reynolds, a mustache.
The
guy?
Longest Yard is her favorite book?
Is that a book made from the movie?
I would give her a lot more credit if she named a Matt Christopher novel. If she was like, she's like, I like
Ice.
Yeah, I like Touchdown for Tommy.
Wait, go back to her.
I like Ice Magic.
Let's do her song.
You gotta do her song. Or do I gotta do her song?
I think. Yeah, I think I did the family thing where I was introducing her.
Oh, okay.
Christine died, remember?
Oh, yeah, Christine died.
You want me to kill off Christine again?
No. I understand you're all scared that you had to leave all of your homes in Syria. But to tell you about what's going to happen to you next, I've brought in Rachel from the Philadelphia 76ers dancers to tell you where you're all going to end up. Rachel! That's right! You're going back to Syria! Fuck you! It's Trump's America now!
Hey guys, get the fuck out of my country!
And
And
here's a cool patriotic dance to go with it!
Don't let the door slam on your big Somalian dicks!
Don't open up the door! I am a cowgirl! I'm a cowgirl! Pew, pew, pew!
Do we have anybody left?
My sweet fucking, the love of my life, Nicolette. Also known as
Nicolette yet?
Nicolette Soder. We haven't gone through her yet.
Jacob, we have to see if we can get a hold of some Sixers dancers.
Oh, yeah. God, look at Nicolette. Oh, she's just perfect.
Nicolette is really hot.
Yeah. Let's go to the next one. There's nothing to make fun of.
I think it's it.
There's nothing to make fun of.
Yeah.
I think we're out.
What about Rachel?
We did Rachel.
Oh, that was
Rachel
it. Was all right. Well, everyone go through your top five. Who's your number one? Obviously, Nicolette Soder is my wife, so she's off the list for everyone else. If you pick her, I will fist fight you.
Let me see Aaliyah one more time. Very first girl.
Yeah, we did Michelle. This girl?
Yeah, we did her too. I just want to go back to her. She's dumb. We never did her song.
Oh, that's your number one?
Julie. It was Julie, the most attainable of all. First grade teacher. Yeah, Julie.
Julie's your number one.
No, that's Christine's number one. Yeah, Clueless, Friends. Got a bod built for fucking plowing out.
Merkface, is that your number one?
No, I like Rachel and Nikki.
Rachel and Nikki?
Yeah.
So Nikki or Rachel? Well, Jay.
Can't decide.
We're taking the votes.
You got to pick.
I really like Nikki. Go back one more time. It's going to be Nikki or go to Jessica. I do like Jessica. No, where's that beefer again? I want her. No, not the fucking muscly dude. Yeah, there you go. The girl from Worcester.
Yeah, you fucking Katie's your number one?
Yeah,
fucking
fuck
Jason, I love you. I'm going to fucking suck you off on the way home. I'm fucking massive. A massive hat.
It looks
for
like
you.
Jesse Mapaluso ate Carly Aquilino.
Oh, yeah. They mixed.
Yeah. I'm just going to pick Katie because I think I can fuck her.
Okay, Katie it is. That's Jay's number one.
I watch The Real Housewives and eat sweet potato fries pretending that they're healthy.
Okay, cool. We got to wrap it up, but we got to finish with everyone's pick. Jacob, maybe pick a girl instead of telling us to end the show. How about that, dude? Do you ever think of that?
I love Nikki, but I'm going to go with Jessica.
You're going to go? You love Nikki, well, but you're going to go
somebody else pick Nikki, right?
Jay.
That's yeah. Jay's girl. So you got to go Jessica.
I'm going with Jessica.
I mean, I hate to say this, but I guarantee Jessica will not go for you.
Oh, by the way, I'm Katie. Oh, don't worry, I'm Worcester. I'm Worcester Katie.
Oh, no, he's Katie. So do you want to go Rachel?
No, then I'm going Nikki.
You're going Nikki.
Christine, who are you picking, that dude in a wig, Nicole?
I think
I'm
going Natasha.
You're going to go Natasha? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I feel like Lou's going to fucking keep the Somali boat pirate.
Dude, don't mess with her. She's my number two, all right? If she happens to Nicolette, I'm calling
her. You like fucking
her.
A girl who's got a bow and a quiver of arrows on her back.
I love it. That's fucking hot as shit.
She's your two?
Jamila, yeah. She's my number two. Who's, all right, so Christine's got one. Jacob's got one. Lou and Andy, you got to pick the two, and then we got to plug our shows and get the fuck out of here.
I like Michelle.
You like Michelle?
Oh, you're not going to be able to hold down this athletic bitch.
Oh, Lou, you never know, though.
You know what it's all about? It's all just about Come With Me Now by the Congos.
I love it. Oh, he come loves- with me now. He's lip-syncing at her as they dance. Merkface, finally, what's yours?
Taking Rachel.
You're going Rachel?
Yeah.
All right, it's official. Go out there. Campers, tell us who's yours. Tell us who your favorite
at
is.
At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook.
Make sure you catch Dan Soder, because he is going to be at Helium in Philadelphia.
Where these girls work.
Where these girls are going to be swarmed there. They're either coming to fight them or fuck them.
Oh, man. What if one of them just happened? Maced me right after the show?
It's going to be their 29th through New Year's Eve. Make sure you check them out there. Get tickets at heliumcomedy.com.
And make sure you go check out Jay this weekend. Thursday, Friday, Saturday at Parlor Live in Seattle. Go to BigJComedy.com for tickets. And we'll see you on Monday.
Follow us always at the Bonfire6M on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook.
All that shit.
Christine, sorry, girls. Sorry, Rodney Carrington. We're just sorry. I'm feeling very
sorry.
Canadian.
Yeah,
today.
Sorry about the girls. Sorry about sorry. Rodney. Rodney, you're jacked. Girls, you're all beautiful.
Make sure to check in on Monday because it's going to be
a bloodbath.
A really funny one. We'll check you guys next week on the Bonfire. Peace.